Greetings. This video refutes argument number 15 from the random flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim. 15. According to Bible, God raised the heavens upon pillars, Job 26:11. But according to Muhammad's Quran, God raised the heavens without pillars, Quran 13:2. Sounds serious to me. Let's take a look first at Job. Job 26:1. Then Job replied, short, sweet. Keep this in mind because it is critical. Job is talking. How you have helped the powerless, how you have saved the arm that is feeble, what advice you have offered to one without wisdom, and what great insight you have displayed. Job is talking. Job is rebuking those lamenting with him. To find out why, you would have to go back in the book of Job. But this video is not a study of Job. Suffice it to say, Job is talking. Who has helped you utter these words, and whose spirit spoke from your mouth? The dead are in deep anguish, those beneath the waters and all that live with them. Still, this is Job talking. The realm of the dead is naked before God. Destruction lies uncovered. He spreads out the northern skies over empty space. He suspends the earth over nothing. Still, Job talking. Voicing his knowledge about God. He wraps up the waters in his clouds, yet the clouds do not burst under their weight. He covers the face of the full moon, spreading his clouds over it. This is how men talk about Almighty God. He marks out the horizon on the face of the waters for a boundary between light and darkness. Remember, this is Job talking. The pillars of the heavens quake aghast at his rebuke. And another translation, the pillars of the heavens tremble and are astonished at his rebuke. And a third translation, the foundations of heaven tremble, they shudder at his rebuke. Remember, this is Job talking. Job is looking for ways to describe the awesome power of Almighty God. This is not Almighty God attempting to give a scientifically impressive miracle of Quranic knowledge. Now I want to give you a deep piece of revelation knowledge for you to meditate upon. Are you ready? I know I'm going to lose some of you. But I first heard this elucidated by Dr. Frederick K.C. Price many years ago. Everything in the Bible is truly recorded, but it is not necessarily a statement of truth. You still there? Everything in the Bible is truly recorded, but it is not necessarily a statement of truth. You still there? This is a critical difference between the inspired Word of God and Islam's ludicrous claim of literal divine authorship. Islam's ludicrous claim that Allah wrote the Quran word for word. Now, it doesn't take a notarized statement from Muhammad to understand where his claim came from. The Torah and Bible were inspired by God. To try and make his Quran seem more authoritative, Muhammad had to one-up the Torah and Bible. Muhammad had to claim Allah literally issued each and every word in the Quran. This Me Too one-upsmanship of Muhammad is also clear in Allah's 99 names. The prophets revealed the 7 Jehovah names of God. Muhammad's Allah therefore needed 99 superlatives. I digress. So a critical error in this argument is to ignore that it is Job, a man, and a bitter man at that, speaking. This is because Islam makes the outrageous claim Allah wrote the Quran word for word, so Mohammedans think the Bible must have this same mythologized origins. Therefore, every statement in the Bible is childishly viewed as God literally speaking, even when men are being quoted. Let's look at one quick example, also from Job. Job 1:10. Have you not made a hedge about him and his house and all that he has on every side? You have blessed the work of his hands, and his possessions have increased in the land. Satan is taunting God here. But stretch out your hand and strike everything he owns, and he will surely curse you to your face. Satan tries to get God to do something to Job. Very well, the Lord told Satan. Everything he owns is in your power. However, you must not lay a hand on Job himself. So Satan left the Lord's presence. The only thing God did was lower the hedge of protection around Job. And there's some question whether God did that or Job did that. Then Satan goes off and Satan begins to destroy Job's world. Until finally Job says, in verse 21, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away." And there is a problem with that statement, because God did not take his world apart. Satan did. Just because someone said it, and God inspired the prophets to record the message, does not mean what they said was God's speech. And those called Muslim will have a very hard time understanding that concept. It is even hard for some Christians to understand and accept. So what does he say about the Quran? "But according to Muhammad's Quran, God raised the heavens without pillars." Quran 13:2. Assad, "It is God who has raised the heavens without any supports that you could see." Pickthall, "Allah it is who raised up the heavens without visible supports." Shakir, "Allah is he who raised the heavens without any pillars that you see." Lalay, "It is he who exalted the heavens without any pillars so that you see them." Muntakab, "Allah the Omnipotent is he who raised the heavens with its spheres lying above or outside of each other and inlaid with heavenly bodies, superstructures that are kept aloft without pillars or visible means." Ah, that Muntakab, he does like to add his own words to every passage Allah snorted. Progressive, "God, who raised the skies without any pillars that you can see." Here, skies is used, not heavens, as in outer space. I hope you can see what the Quran really says. The Quran does not say, "no pillars." The Quran says, "no visible pillars." And that is a very different statement. But you have to parse words like Bill Clinton is talking. "But according to Muhammad's Quran, God raised the heavens without pillars." Not exactly. The Quran says no visible pillars. And this is a side note, but it really relates. For years, I listened to Lance Armstrong say, "I've never tested positive for." I have never tested positive for. Not, "I have never used." And talking about it years ago, I would raise that exact point. His declaration was never the clear way to say it. Now that the truth has come out, it should make sense to you. Muhammad's statement is clear that Muhammad thought there were pillars. They were just invisible. So which is less accurate? The claim the Bible says there are pillars? Or Muhammad's claim of invisible pillars? Either way, this poor Mohammedan's argument doesn't make him or his religion look good. Does it matter to you, O Muslim, that this is the best your religion can do? O Muslim, can your brain see anything wrong with the claims of this argument? Or are you simply mad at the Christian from Texas who rips Islam's arguments to shreds? I challenge you, O Muslim, to stop and think. Did I misquote a single word from the Quran? No. I show you where the Quran says there are no pillars that you can see. And I show you that statement does not mean there are no pillars. Yet the argument tries to claim no pillars. Now, I'm not Allah. And maybe Allah is smarter than me. but I am smart enough to know if I want to say there are no pillars, I say there are no pillars. I don't say there are no pillars visible. I pray Almighty God would allow you to think with the brain God gave you and be ashamed of the religion that needs such foolishness. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.